Babe.
Don't do it.
Babe.
No. No.
Really?
Hi everybody, welcome back to another video. My name is Rebecca, for those of you guys who don't know, and today, as you can see by the title, I am engaged to a guy that I met on Hinge. And I wanted to make this video because I believe the most popular video on my channel is the one that I made about online dating. And so a lot of you guys have been asking about whether I met somebody and any updates that I have about my dating life. And so here I am to update you guys and kind of share with you guys my story, my side of the story of how I met my fiance. So without further ado, let's just get right into the video. So about a year ago, last June, I began my online dating journey for the first time, and I went on Hinge. And I remember telling myself that I was only going to be on Hinge for about a month. And so I went on a couple of dates. It didn't really work out. And so I was kind of discouraged and just kind of waiting around until the time was up. And towards the end of that month, I got a like from this guy. His name is Peter. And Peter basically just liked me. And I remember being a little bit surprised, because this is how judgmental you can get on Hinge or online dating. But I remember just looking at his profile, and he had a very nice profile. It was very clean. He had good pictures. I believe his little blurbs were funny. But I remember just thinking that we wouldn't mesh well, or we would never connect, because he's like 6 years older than me, first of all. And his profile just seemed very like mature, which is not a bad thing. He just kind of came off like he was very like well put together, like he looked like a business guy. And I just have never dated anybody like that before. I've only dated guys that are my age or at most 3 years older. But because I was doing this online dating thing and trying to be very open with just getting to know people, I accepted his like and liked him back. And I just basically said, "Hey, Peter, how are you doing? Nice to meet you." And I believe it was about an hour later, I got a response from him, and he said, "Hey, Rebecca, it was great meeting you at Blink Ministries." And that's when I remembered, oh my gosh, I had met this guy before. And how I met him was, I met him in college when I was like 21, 22. I followed my brother to this nonprofit that helps people experiencing homelessness. And so my brother had been volunteering there for a couple months, and so I just went with him. And I had an interest in, I guess, helping people who are experiencing homelessness. And so I went and volunteered with him. And I remember meeting the guy who founded the organization, and I just made the connection that, oh, this guy, this Peter, is that guy that I met. Even though our meeting was very brief and really quick, I just said hi to him. I think I assumed that he was married, because there was another lady next to him, and I just remember thinking, oh, that's so sweet that this couple like made this nonprofit together, and they're just trying to pour into this community. And so I just thought it was really sweet, and I just went on to volunteering and never thought of it again. But anyways, yeah. And so I was just like, oh yeah, that's you. I remember now. But anyways, we started to talk, and he asked me a lot of questions about like my photography, videography stuff, and some just advice about cameras. And that went on for about like 2 weeks. And I think in those 2 weeks, I didn't really get the vibe that he was super interested in me. He kept saying that he was really busy and didn't really ask much about me. He asked a lot about like cameras. I think I also had a different expectation for him, just because he seemed like such a go-getter. I mean, he started his own nonprofit, he has his own business and things like that. And so I think I just assumed that, well, if he is such a go-getter and like is proactive, I would think that he would ask me about like, if he was interested about like my dating life or like what I'm looking for, why I'm on Hinge, things of that nature. But I got none of that. Honestly, I felt like I was networking with him, and so I was kind of confused, because like my advice, I think I was talking to like one other guy at the time. And so I was I was not super invested in him. After 2 weeks had passed, I was getting a little bit frustrated and I just wanted to know if he was interested in me or not. And if he was, great. If not, great, but I can't waste my time talking to you if you don't see this potentially going anywhere. So anyways, and I asked him,
"Hey Peter, it's been so nice getting to know you, but I just feel like you're really like busy. And I don't know, do you think it's a good time for you to date?"
And he responded saying that, "Oh no, I am busy, but I am up for dating and I want to date and I want to ask you out to coffee." And so after I asked that question and he answered in that way, I got a little bit of confirmation thinking that, oh, he is interested romantically at some sort of capacity. And so we set a date and we met up at Green Lake in Seattle. It was really hot that day. But I remember before going to meet him, I was hecka nervous because, like I mentioned before, because I haven't dated anybody that much older than me, I didn't know what to expect. But thankfully, when I met him, he was very deep and he could be very serious, but he was also super thoughtful. He really was somebody that cared about other people, and I think that was really refreshing. And I remember on that day, I did a lot more listening than talking, and it was just like a really nice conversation. And I think even though I was nervous, I just kept telling myself, you know what, it's okay if it doesn't work out. My job right now is just to care for him and just listen, be a friend. And I had to leave I think an hour and a half into our date at Green Lake because I had like another meeting for work. And so we said our goodbyes, and like a day later, he texts me asking if we could hang out again. And so I said yes, and we met like that for I think a month before we made it official. Yeah, things did move really quickly with him. I mean, this month will be our 1 year. I'm really grateful that I met somebody like him, and I feel more sure about him than any other guy that I have ever dated before, because I've never met somebody who is so consistent with not only his love for me, but for his love for his family, his friends, like people around him. He is such a consistent guy, and he is somebody that is really reflective and gets help when he needs it. He listens, he can admit when he's wrong. That's what helped me really fall in love with him. So anyways, thanks so much for watching. If you guys want to hear his side of the story, please like this video and I'll bring him on here. So anyways, I hope you guys have a really good day. Bye.